In this lecture, we're going to discuss the challenging problem of recovering three-dimensional shape information from a single shaded image. So first, let's take a look at why this is a hard problem. So here's what's given to us. We're given an image of the object, a simple object in this case. The image is I. We know everything we need to about the light source, the direction of the light source and the brightness of the light source. And we are also given the reflectance properties of the object itself. And we'll assume for our purposes here that the reflectance of the object is uniform over the entire object. And we know that this combination of the source and the reflectance can be used to compute what's called a reflectance map, RPQ. What does RPQ give us? For any given surface normal, surface orientation PQ, we can plug in the PQ value into the reflectance map, and it'll tell us what the intensity it is that it'll produce in the image. But here, of course, we want to go the other way. We want to go from an intensity value to figure out what the surface orientation is. So the question we're asking is, can we estimate the surface gradient PQ from a single intensity value? And we know the answer is no. And the reason is, given an intensity value right here, that corresponds to what's called an isobrightness contour in the reflectance map. And what that's telling you is that there's an entire family of PQ values, an infinite number of PQ values that would generate the same brightness value in the image. So all this to say that the problem of recovering three-dimensional shape from a single shaded image is a severely under-constrained problem. And so our goal here is to actually find ways to constrain the problem and then solve it. So this is our problem here, to develop a method for recovering three-dimensional shape information from a single shaded image of an object. So first, we're going to take a look at human perception. We know that you and I are pretty good at looking at the shading of an object and figuring out, at least qualitatively, what the shape of the object is. So let's take a look at how this is possible for humans. It turns out that the only reason we're able to do this is because we invoke a series of assumptions. So we'll take a look at what those assumptions are. It turns out that similar assumptions are going to be needed to develop a shape from shading algorithm, which is what we'll talk about next. We'll first come up with a set of assumptions, map those assumptions into mathematical constraints, and then develop an algorithm to recover shape from a single shaded image.